What would you feel like if you were wearing this out in public?
I wouldn't.
You wouldn't wear this in public?
I mean, like just going around shopping?
Yeah.
Like, hey, everybody.
Like imagine I'll take that coat.
I'm Chris.
I'm Kevin.
And today we are testing
a meditation headband.
Yes, so this is called the Muse II. Brain sensing headband.
So why do people meditate? Tell me all about that.
Why do people meditate?
Yeah,
why do people meditate? I don't know.
You meditate.
I do meditate because it. I do think that sort of like if individuals can be mindful and almost step outside of themselves and see themselves walking through this world, we wouldn't be so preoccupied with ourselves the entire time. We'd be able to enjoy this very short thing that is life.
Have you been asked that question before?
No.
This is like some Flowers for Algernon shit right here. The busier you are, the more ideal a candidate you are for meditation.
Exactly. So the idea I think behind this product is for those that know that there are benefits behind the curtain of meditation but have no idea how to get into it. You want to tell us what it does?
I think it's going to measure our brain activity and it's going to tell us if we're meditating the right way or not.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know exactly how.
When you get distracted.
Mm-hmm.
Eye movements can interfere with signal quality.
You. You don't think the thing is going to notice, but it does. And then the weather goes crazy and it starts raining harder and thunderstorming. And then when you can like bring yourself back, then you'll hear the weather on the app calm.
Wow.
Look at that.
So I'm starting to think that we cannot do this next to each other.
No.
It's a little distracting.
So we should meditate on our own.
Oh, now it's really raining. Oh boy. I'm focused on my breath, and then I'll get distracted and I'll not be thinking about my breath and then the rain will start. 15 birds. That means I was pretty zenning. I think what we actually have to do, because I'm not a meditation expert, is to talk and speak with somebody who does meditation a lot. And I know just the guy.
So we're with Ben Tershin. He's a meditation teacher. If you want to check this out, I don't know, have you read about this?
It's a form of neurofeedback, and there's different types of neurofeedback, and this is Z-score, which is meant to keep your mind in a certain place of brain activity.
Uh-huh.
And what this trains is a form of meditation that's very much centered on focusing and concentrating, which is how most people know meditation. But the good news is, not all meditation is the same.
What was your result from doing 5 minutes of this meditation?
I mean, I did it right before bed and I slept well, but I'm realizing that I usually sleep well.
I did it in the morning before work. And the impact was nothing.
Yeah.
Well, I think that you gotta try this Muse thing. Okay.
I think I'm good. All right.
All right.
It picked up on, I was thinking about what I wanted for lunch. And up on, hey, he's not thinking about his breath right now.
Yeah.
And I kind of was like smiling a little bit. I'm like, it's good.
It works. So looks like on that round, you got 717 com points.
Yeah.
Now, how many com points? You got more than me.
Yeah, it was six something.
It was six something. So yeah. Ben got the most com points. He got 27 birds. Tied with Kevin on birds.
Wow.
Hey, okay guys, like, you know, let's just remember what this is about.
The meditation bullies.
Yeah. Kevin is clearly winning at meditation.
It. I can't discourage this enough.
You've never meditated before, you don't even know how to wrap your mind around it, pun intended. Would this be a good way to sort of get into it?
I think it's a way to get into it.
Okay.
I appreciate you not wanting to
say
negativity.
If we have this understanding that there's different types, this is really good beginner a beginner avenue for that specific type of focus concentration meditation. What I teach is really meant to de-excite the mind and put the body into a deep state of rest. We're not focusing, we're not concentrating, we're not trying to actually control the mind at all. What we're gonna do today is all about effortlessness. And that's about a willing surrender to the experience that you're having, which is very opposite to what the Muse is training, which is control your experience. Mm-hmm. This is actually let the experience happen. But place one hand on your belly and one hand on your chest. As we inhale, I want you to feel your belly expand against your hand. And as you exhale, I want you to feel your belly pull away from your hand.
Ben's meditation was all about, like, if you get distracted and you drift off, that's A-okay. And then as soon as you realize you got distracted and drift off, you come back to it. Mm-hmm. But the realization that you got distracted means that it's working, right. Means that you allowed yourself to get distracted and that you could come back. If you never got distracted, then you wouldn't be meditating correctly. The Muse is all about don't get distracted. You're bad. You're bad. Right. You're bad. You're bad. Okay, you're good. You're good. You're bad. Oh. I would not recommend getting the Muse. It gamifies meditation. Mm-hmm. I never come out of it more peaceful or more focused.
Okay. For me, the issue is the price point. If I'm a person who's never meditated before and I want to learn how to meditate, I could drop $250 or less by going to an actual human like Ben who could teach me how to meditate.
Or you could download, like, for $199, $299 Deepak Chopra's like 45-minute guided meditation.
I'm not getting direct feedback from that. How do I know if it's working or not?
Hmm.
This is giving me direct feedback connected to my brain and showing me that it is working or it's not.
My point is that the feedback it's giving you is counterproductive to meditation.
Fair. That's fair. Unless you get really good at it. And then now you're just hearing birds.
I think there's only one way to find out if we got really good at it, and that's to let's have check a our Muse bird. Competition.
Oh, Muse
right?
off!
A Muse off.
Because meditation is all about competition.
What are you doing over there?
This is absurd. Like a goddamn hurricane over here.
I totally destroyed
you. Yeah, I got crushed.
What do we got? Oh my god.
Look how hard it was for me to get into the zone.
Wow. All right, I got 26 birds. How many birds did you get?
10
birds. Oh. I had zero recoveries because I didn't
even
leave
need
the
any.
Zone,
you
bro.
Never left the zone.
That's fine, you f***ing meditate. Yeah. Well, regardless, I think we can now say that this meditation headband Muse.
The Muse.
Has been ink. Tested. Is it connected yet?
No, of course
not.